Hello, everybody, all over the world! Hello, welcome to HiGPS number 140. It's the dominant heavy loadout, yes. So, last week we took a look at Alex's style, the former retired. Probably we'll see him returning because nobody ever quits TF2, it always drags you back, doesn't it? Yes, very subtle. So, we saw him playing in Highlander, you know, 9 versus 9 competitive stuff. And he was playing heavy using the minigun, the sandwich, and the gloves running urgently, which seems to be the most popular and most used loadout for heavy. Usually we see some people mix it up. We rarely see a shotgun unless it's, you know, a fat scout or something like that. Or we just never see any variation whatsoever, as this seems to be what everybody is using. And the reason for this is that this combination is pretty good, very minigun heavy. So we're gonna go right into the first replay and just look at it today. We have a lot of replays we're gonna go through, so let's take a look at that. There is a floating minigun, everything is under control, just calm down. Yes, so we're gonna open with me playing heavy here on this map. First, I'm going to do this, because you just do that. And then we're not going to opt to do any kind of using gloves running urgently right now. And oh yeah, we got gloves running urgently, yes. So when you pull those up, you run 30% faster, which is almost as quick as sniper, engineer, pyro, spy, but not as fast. Nearly as fast. It's like one or two off or something like that. So, the main bad thing about the gloves ring urgently, of course, is that you take mini crits while you do the damage. So, yeah, first we get a Domain pick here. Medic comes up. We're actually covered in PP right now. As you can see, our invisible. And we're actually burning it. Oh, we're going to have a sandwich because we're invisible, because that's how replays work. And yet, we heal ourselves up with the sandwich. And we're like, all right, cool. So we killed the Devil Man. But, you know, people in TF2, when you get killed by heavy, you start to have a grudge. And grudges always come back to haunt you. So we're just doing the regular jump and spin minigun in the air for momentum. We're just capping the point here with our scout. Playing on 5 CP map, which surprisingly was not the most submitted map for today. It's usually payload. And then you can do the grew skips, where you jump and switch and stuff like that. So we're gonna be, yeah, just gonna run with the grew. Grab it. Oh shit! Oh shit! Devil Man with 20% extra damage and shield, and this thing over my head means I take mini crits. Shit, 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 and he just two shots us, and we're fucking dead at full health. So that was the introduction to this loadout. We saw everything. Minigun kills people, and sandwich heals you and others when you throw it to them, and grues kill you if you're out of position. So the grue went over a nerf a while back. By the way, this is Spitfire 25X, playing a little heavy here on Badwater, taking out those pyros, because heavies are good against pyros. What was I talking about? It was something very important and very noteworthy. I know people on YouTube can just go back and be like, yeah, this is what you said, but you forgot, because I mentioned Spitfire, and I was going to say something about Spitfire, and then I forgot. Anyway! Yeah, the grue nerf, that was it, yes. Before you only lost 6 health and you got additional speed, so you can like do the skips where you really didn't lose any health and it was just a pure upgrade. You do also do less damage with this gloves running urgently, so that's something to point out. Keep in mind, a bushwhack, a sniper, will do full crit on you if you wear this gloves running urgently and he hits you. However, when you run with it, it's like you're covered in Jurati, so you gotta be careful. So we saw, like, before the nerf, we saw a lot of players, especially me, myself, just rushing everywhere with this, losing 6 health, not all that important. But now you take 33% additional damage, which is really a lot when you think about it. Also comes into play when considering how much health you have left. Because you will get in a position where you have very low health, and what do you do? Do you run away slower with less damage taken? Or do you run away with less health and more damage taken but with higher speeds? That's kind of the thing. But from my experience, when you have below like 90 health, it doesn't really matter if you use the gloves running urgently or not when you're escaping, because you die just as much, it seems. So we're having Spitfire here. Not use the gloves around Urn a little bit. It's kind of backing off from that Pyro. You do get that additional speed, so you can use it for some trickery. I think you can do a double bounce before you lose all momentum here. Of course, this Pyro trying to deny him going around here with his Compression Blast. Another Pyro comes in with the Phlogiston Air Dust, gonna get anything done. Throwing the sandwich, not throwing the sandwich, just keeping it. Another Pyro comes around, man. If one Heavy is tearing your team apart, you better go Pyro to make sure that you die. So yeah. So the gloves running energy definitely being a bit more balanced right now. But they keep in mind, like, if you run into a scout with proper aim and a scatter gun, I think he kills you in like two shots, I think, with the mini crits. And also, ah, yes, important. We learned from Alex's play that he looks around a lot, making sure he doesn't get stabbed that much. We're seeing Spitfire do a little bit of that. Not as much as he should, but he definitely turns around and he's definitely oriented what he's up to and what he's doing. So he's gonna jump down here in position, doing some damage. There's the scout who just decided to hover in midair, and he kills the medic, and he's like, well, it's, yeah, uber popped because forced. And he is bulletproof, and this scout's gonna die. Yeah, dies in the stairs, and he goes back to throw the sandwich to his medic. There's a couple of other medics, and now I think they just roll straight on through here. To speed things up, he just goes like this. See him use the sandwich, not that much, but mostly some group play. Very standard. This is something you see on the pubs all the time. And the reason this is so popular is, one, the heavy gets to get to the action faster. You just have to be a more careful when you arrive. Like, it's better to just take down the gloves running urgently once you get there. So now we're going to look at a point where it's really no point in running gloves running urgently. This is Dust Bowl, yeah. We have burgers here. It's from CB-M, the happy face, parentheses larger than Nutty dot dot dot, which is a clan. You know, when you're defending on last point on any map, really, you do not need the gloves running urgently because you're not leaving anywhere, and you have no urgent. You're better off using the Fists of Steel or just not using them at all. So he's just gonna hang around here for a bit, not really achieve a lot. Jump around a corner, see a soldier, take a couple of rocks in the face, and be like, oh shit, 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 shit. Go up here, okay. Run back, pull out the sandwich. Eat the sandwich, because keep in mind, if you eat the sandwich and you pick up a health pack, you replenish your sandwich. Yes, everybody knows this. This is useful information. Also known as axioms, for those who study and are like, that was a really funny joke if you ever went to university or college or have generally mildly educated yourself in the terms of psychology or something like that. So we see burgers just hanging around like a heavy. Nothing too interesting. Hasn't really used the gloves running urgently at all. And one of the things I really want to showcase for this episode is that usage of all these three. Like the minigun primarily, and then a lot of sandwich action, and then a lot of gloves running urgently action, just to see why. But in this situation, you don't really need it. Oh, he runs to get the health back, and then he stops, and he eats the sandwich. And then he grabs the health back. And I feel like we've seen this before. So why don't we just speed it up, huh? Let's do that. Speed it up, goes back, shoots, just hangs out in this area. What Burgers is doing is called defending, and that it's when you occupy one area and then you just never leave the area. And if you do, you fucking die. To the double sentry sniper offense! With the soldier back up. Good. Can't imagine why they can't push last on Dust Bowl. Fucking map's broken. So as we move on, we will go on to the next replay, which is... Yes. We kind of covered this. This is kind of like, everybody's seen this, everybody knows this, so this is kind of just an episode to make sure that we know the same thing. Ah, spy! He cloaked. You shoot a bit around? Yeah, I'm not going to waste any energy chasing that spy. Keep in mind, spies can only hurt you when they are visible, so you will see them if you turn around and are slightly oriented about things. So, we're going to be playing heavy. This is me. going up the low ground here, trying to push Foundry last here. Taking out two power classes by myself. There's a sniper back there covered in Gerardi right now. Can't do too much, but I'll put my back against the wall. Eating a sandwich. Just so you can see my ultra cool view model here and my loadout and all that stuff. Look at this. No hats and nothing really. Oh, that's a downer. So I had no loadout, no hats apparently. Alright, cool, whatever. Grabbing a health pack. So I can't really go in there, as it's just me and there's a bunch of blue guys. Let's just take a look, you know what's out there. It's a mini sentry, which you know are imba broken. They have like 100 health, can't move. Super imba. We have an engineer on the roof here, there's a dispenser. There's a scout, and I'm low on health. And we have a pyro coming up, and there's another scout here, and their spawn is right here, and no one else is coming. But most likely, it will be 4v1 scenario if I go in. So that's not really good, even if I'm a heavy. So, yeah, we're just gonna go back to our engineer who has set up a forward base here with a level 3 sentry protecting everything, making sure to have everything clustered in case one demo man comes along. You lose fucking everything. So, yeah, run over the health pack, and now we're gonna try. Well, that pushing over there didn't work. Let's try this way. Yeah, gonna be doing this little dude here. And oh, there's a pyro. They can air blast me around this corner all day. I can't really pass here. I got a couple of kills, but you know, I can't really do that much because snipers are good. I'm already in Gerardi, and there's two pyros over here. So if I pop in, they will just burn me because there's two of them. There's, they have a huntsman sniper and another sniper with the piss shooter, the Sydney sweeper, stuff like that. So not a lot we can do. Oh no, a broken imba, imba sentry. And yeah, just gonna kill that instantly. You know, 100 health isn't all that much. And yeah, we're gonna try and make another push here. See pyro air blasting us around a corner, so we're just doing pot shot damage at this point in time. And can't really do all that much. We have a medic, gets stabbed by a spy because the medic thinks it's really important to look at us instead of around, and gets killed. We're still here, we're the only ones attacking. We have a spy who decides to not do anything. And then, yeah, that didn't really work. Can't really push through there. So we're just gonna have another sandwich bite here at the dispenser. And then we might try and push from another angle. Let's try the high ground. Yeah, so you see we systematically tried, like, let's try pushing from here. Alright, that didn't work, bunch of guys. Let's try pushing around here. Can't, denied by pyros. Let's try go from the high ground. Yeah, let's see how that goes. So let's try and get to the high ground with my soldier buddy. He has the buff banner and everything. We have a sniper up here as well. We have high ground. No one else is here. I will make sure to kill anyone that comes up the stairs because I know that if we can just hold this high ground, we can win eventually if my team at just any point in time would show up here. So here we are just hanging out in the top. And somehow our bullet shoots through walls. That's nothing in Team Fortune. They're like, yeah, look at this smile. Look how happy he is. Look how happy he is. He's like, yeah, I have to eat a sandwich. I get to eat a sandwich. Scouts are a bitch, right? So yeah, when you eat sandwich, you're kind of vulnerable. So look out for that. So we're just gonna move on, and this is Gozizan's portion where he sent me a million bajillion replays that were all really mediocre. So we're just gonna speed things up here, and let's see how many times he checks his back. He runs, and spins up his minigun. All right, we're in combat. We can slow things down, normal speed. It's currently ubercharged. Don't really need to check your back. But, oh, that was a spy. That was a spy. Oh, a spy behind him. And I'm not sure if you heard the stab, but you should. Medic stabs the medic in the ankle. Turns around, kills the spy. Yes, excellent. Checking your back. The counter to spy is turning around. If you just do that, you'll be surprised how less you get stabbed as a heavy. And he's just bringing the pain, killing the imba mini sentries, you know, as they build in front of him. Really showing how good they are at dying and getting blown up. Going down on low ground. Gonna be killing the scout eventually with a little help of his pyro friend. Just occupying this area. Not by being fat, but just being in that general area. So, yeah, he's just hanging around, and we'll check his back anytime soon. This would be a prime time for a spy to come, and he checks his back. I'm just gonna try and save his medic. He's like, dude, I got the sandwich, dude, medic, dude, I got... Here's your sandwich. Fucking eat it. It's, oh, demo man, shoot him! Yeah, we got him, yep, easy operation.
Easy operation.
We got to stop not doing that, Sonic Boom.
Sonic Boom!
That's what I said, Guile. You should really... enjoy your tune more. So, going back into position here, having an Uber popped on him on this Razorback Sniper. As you can see, the Razorback was fairly effective in protecting the Sniper of being absolutely demolished by the minigun here. And, yeah, Spy can't really do all that much. And, yeah, Ghost is on defense. The end. So let's look at some more back-checking, because checking your back is something that's very important, that's a heavy, and you should do it a lot. We saw Alex have a very good habits of doing that. We see that Gozan isn't quite as good, but he certainly does fare a lot better than the heavies that are like... I guess if you could... kind of... compare it to, like, dogs. Like, dogs don't understand the concept of looking up. When they are like outside, they understand of looking up when you're like at a table and you have food there, because they can smell it. But if you try to like, if there's a cat like on top of a car, like on the hood, and you try to teach your dog to look up at the dog won't understand, because everything in the dog's life is from here and down. Everything's like, nothing is up. So I feel like a lot of heavies on pubs have the same thing, except not looking back, but they're like, well, everything's in front of me, I don't have to, you know, check my back because everything's in front of me. Another one thing, you know, if you get stabbed a lot, just turn around a bit more. So yeah, this would be a prime time for a spy to attack here. I would really like to see Gozan turn around here. He does. Ah, spy, get him. Ah, and a scout as well. Not a spy, but still. Yeah, spies always get you when you are preoccupied and busy. So that is one thing to keep in mind. Keep in mind, yeah, like, right now I could get stabbed. You 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 could still get stabbed. But as you can see, there is no spy behind him, so he is fine for now. If you have a good feeling of how many spies the enemy team has, in this case, one, if you kill him, you kind of have a good timer and a good, you know, idea of when he'll be back. So if you know they only have one spy, like, let's say you play Highlander and you kill a spy, you know that you don't have to check your back for X amount of seconds. But now Ninja Spy, he's back. And he's going for Gozizan. He doesn't like him because Gozizan is second fragging to Tech Magic on the server. And Gozizan is taking the high ground advantage and then giving it up for free for some reason. And let's go down to stop the cart here. There's the demo man who shoots a couple of pipes and then he's lagging. He's playing on 1 frame per second, which is really, really hard. And he's like, well, I might as well just go down here and... oh... and that sniper taunted with a guitar while he was dead. Not sure how he did that, but he did. So here's another thing that that is actually viable for everybody in the game, whatever class you play, and that is going out of your way to survive, like running like really far and getting a health pack. And as soon as you get into combat the next time, you just instantly die. That is something that happens a lot. Everywhere. Like, it happens in Highlander, it happens in Sixes, where players are just, like, try to survive for the longest amount of time, and they spend, like, 20 seconds doing it, and then they just fucking die anyway. So, be acceptive of you just being dead, especially when on blue team. You do not have to be conservative of your life on blue team. On blue team, you're basically cannon fodder constantly. So we see an Uber popped here for Gozan. He's used the gloves running early to get in position here. Shooting this engineer, taking out this medic who decided not to move. He was maybe a pacifist. He was like, well, maybe he's like a T-Rex. Maybe if I won't move, he won't see me and then I can survive. But Gozan on the high ground here, and his enemy team's not being dogs, actually understanding to look up when bullets are coming from the top. And, oh, it's a spy! Spy! Get the spy! Yeah, the spy survived. And... okay, push the cart. Push the cart. And Gozan's like, yeah, I'm gonna throw a sandwich. Oh, well, okay, I'm just gonna pick it up again. Yes. That's a good thing. You throw sandwiched your teammate, he fucking dies, and you're like, well, might as well pick it up, you know, don't want this to spoil. And oh no, the enemy team, that's a buff banner, taking a lot of damage, this demo man doesn't know which way is the front, where he should defend. He has another medic with him. Oh shit, crits, oh, he's medic died, oh, this is horrible, okay, retreat, retreat, okay, I got a sandwich, run away, run away. Eat the sandwich. Alright. Okay, and run away, run more away. Grab the health pack. Alright, so he got that sandwich, he refilled his sandwich bar. And now he's just gonna go to the front and fucking die. Oh, he got heals from a medic. Excellent! I might be remembering this replay a little wrong, but that's okay! And then he dies. Look at this dead heavy. Look how dead he is. And that's what I mean. Like, Gozan spent a fair decent amount of time just running back. Like, he ate a sandwich here. That's fine. He could have eaten it here. That would be the same. Or just here. Or, like, even in the combat zone. But instead, he goes like, well, I'm going to go here. And then I'm going to grab this health kit. And then I'm going to run around, and then I'm going to attack. Even though there's medics here, and I don't really need the sandwich, it has a recharge bar, and if I really wanted, I could have just, you know, gone on the right side, picked up that thing while being in combat. So, that's something to keep in mind. Like, doing, like, this kind of extra stuff, if it takes longer than 20 seconds, and your team has a teleporter, it's not worth it. Not worth it. Sometimes dying is better. Because then you come with the next wave of your teammates. So dying is actually better in that case. And there's surprisingly a lot of people who don't, you know, understand this. Especially because I'm such a fucking genius at explaining things. So the next replay is something that a lot of players that think Heavy is a fucking broken noob class that everybody can play and is like super easy. And that's from the other team point of view, where Heavy is like the most heavy medic is like the most broken thing ever. And when you're playing the Heavy, the enemy team just sucks, like, so bad. So, we're gonna watch something, and we're gonna comment on it, and this happens quite often, and don't do this if you're on the other team. Bye. You will lose so badly if you do this. So, we're just waiting for everything to open, the gates and stuff like that. 10 seconds. Alright, 3, 2, 1, go, and we're out. So yeah, building a sentry there, because why not? You do like to lose your sentry within 2 seconds of the gates opening. So yeah, that was one sentry and a soldier. Notice it that what is going to happen is that the entire enemy team is going to attack Gozizan one at a time. And here's the thing, if you're a heavy and you have a medic and the enemy team attacks you one at a time, you will kill their entire team. Because a heavy requires some focus damage, focus firing. And right now it was like 4-5 versus 1 on that sentry, so of course it died immediately. And the red team is just using the strategy of having 2 engineers and no sentry whatsoever. Here's a soldier again, just going alone. And if you go alone and you encounter a heavy and you're not like really, really sure what you want to do, you're gonna die. As he goes on, he's just hanging out with his team, waiting for reinforcements and stuff like that. And pushing the carts, stuff like that, and be like, yeah, gloves are running urgently. Yes, we can use those for faster movement and go to the ceiling. Oh, like this. Like this, this goes to like an IQ check, you know, like checking your intelligence. You see your teammates run up the stairs, and then you hear a blast, and then you see like your teammate's arm, right? Or like his hand, or gib, or whatever. Like, any normal person in, like, any other game would be like, fuck it, we're not going up there. It's like bombs and shit, we're not going up there. But in Team Fortress 2, it means the demo man detonated his bombs. There's no sticky traps. Fucking let's go. Let's go up the stairs where we can't see what's on top. Let's go. Ba-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-dum. And there's actually a pirate in front of us. And yeah, killing that soldier one-on-one, killing that medic one-on-one, turning around, checking your back. So guys on the low ground here, sniper doesn't see him, kills him one-on-one. Kills the soldier, turns around, doesn't kill the soldier yet, the soldier's really weak, the soldier should have run away, but the soldier's like, never give up, never surrender, and if you've ever been killed throughout this door, well, yeah, that's quite common. Spy comes around and immediately decloaks, because, you know, he kind of had, you know, Okay, Deadringer guys, if you spam the Deadringer thing, you will most likely just trigger the Deadringer and uncloak right in front of the dude, right? But what you can do is just hold down the right mouse button when you use the Deadringer and this won't happen. It's called a premature decloakination. So as you can see, enemy team attacking him one at a time, goes on, doesn't fucking die, because I think he has a medic. Yes, he has overheal, and he has a medic, so he doesn't fucking die ever. So, that's one thing, you know. Let's see, do we still meet people one at a time? Let's see. Yep, meets a sniper and a spy one-on-one. Well, you're like, oh, but, well, there's actually a lot of red people here. If you count, as I did in my math class, we see there's 1, 2, 3 reds here, and that's actually a 3-on-1 scenario. No, because the heavy has heals, that's 2, and the pirates there is that 3. That's 3-on-3, that's 1-on-1. So, yeah. And his team is just kicking ass. The soldier's like, well, I don't guess movement is, like, you know, anything a part of my plan, so I guess I'll just stand here and kill the heavy 1-on-1. Spy comes up, medic spots him, kills him. Good medic work there, having unusual hats, which, you know, always implies the skill of the highest caliber. And he's just hanging around, and oh, another demo man attacking him one at a time. Yeah, cool. I'm sure if you just keep hurling people at him, eventually he will die, especially pirates who run with the flare gun outside of the spawn. And, yeah, nobody's pushing the card. Demo man attacks once again, head-on. And nobody's really pushed the car or something out here. It's a car. Let's just speed things up. Because you see where this is going. This happens a lot. So you're saying, alright, Uber popped. Yeah, you can't do shit when you are against something when it's Uber except run away or fucking die. So we can do an hey, push the car. Hey, victory!
Easy operation.
So yes. So, sometimes Gozizan will send me a replay and be like, oh my god, my team is so fucking bad, right? Or like, oh shit, I ran out of ammo. And I think this one was entitled, like, fuck it, I'm out of ammo, or like, something like that. But, having basic strategies in positioning could easily have solved your ammo problem, right? So here Gozizan just shoots around, does some spy checks, something like that. He has a medic with some minigun, a pyro here, attacks him one at a time. Kills the pyro, picks up the ammo, he currently has full ammo. He's gonna be shooting. Ah, there's a cart here, you know, gotta be pushing that. But goes on, he's like, well, you know, I'm a heavy and I don't really feel like pushing the cart. Even though he could at any point in time just jump on this fucking cart and start pushing it, because there's literally a person that can stop him. If he just at any point in time, of course, just jumped on the cart and pushed it. But Gozizan's like, no, I have a great plan. I'm gonna go down here because I'm such a fucking genius here. I study medical science, because he actually does. And he just goes up here behind the cart, and nobody is pushing the cart, and there is literally nothing the enemy team can do about it if he so desired to push the cart. The enemy drops down right in front of him. He kills everybody, and there's a mini sentry there, and the mini sentry drops a lot of ammo, but of course, Gozizan is not gonna pick up any of it. He actually jumps over the ammo, which lies here. There's a lot of ammo in this metal cart here, but he jumps over that, kills a heavy who drops a minigun, does not pick it up, and then he goes and gets the crits, and there is a cart here that is moving, and this cart has a dispenser in it, which gives you ammo, but Gozizan is still shooting here off the enemy spawn. He could at any point in time just jump on the cart and ensure their victory, but instead he's gonna go up on top and go forward and not find any ammo as the enemies jump down. Yes, well, yes, high ground advantage. I guess that's good for something. He's out of ammo. If he only knew a source where there was ammo, he could have stopped this. And he runs on the cart and he has the gloves running early and he just fucking dies. And he's like, damn it, I ran out of ammo. Shit. Ugh. It's like when you play DayZ and you try to chop down a tree and it says you have to be in a forest to get wood. Not in a forest, but there's a tree right fucking there. Ugh. I forgot what this one was called. Fuck, what was it called? Oh yeah, it's called Super Engineers. Yeah, Super Engineers. That was this one was called. Yes. So yeah, this is gonna be Barnabas goes on stale. He's kind of a hero. Stuff like that. People having a good laugh on Gozizan's behalf. Yeah, that's good. Because Gozizan sends me, he sends me a lot of replays, which is good. But he doesn't do a good job of filtering them. And sometimes he's just like, ran out of ammo. It's like the only title. There's nothing else. I literally have no idea what's going to happen. So we're just waiting for the gates to open and everything like that. And yeah, we're just still waiting. People having a good laugh. Gates are open. That's your cue. Time to play Team Fortress 2. Yes, attack. Okay, look at. Oh, the sentry. Level 2. Shoot it, shoot it, shoot it. Yeah, uber popped. Yeah. Bum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum. There we go. Coming in here, dealing a lot of damage. That's the second sentry takes out. Notice the lack of dispensers. Oh, mini sentry taking that out. No problem. Easy operations. It goes is on. Running around and kill everything, it looks like. Did not run out of ammo this time, because there's literally ammo all over the field. Killing a sniper. And lagging a bit. And oh, there's a demo man down there. Do some damage to him. Check your back for spies. Yep, did. Check your back for spies. Excellent.
Easy operation.
Yes, easy, easy, easy. Picking up the ammo. Oh, another sentry. Well, how will we ever kill that? Said goes on as he killed it. So yeah, stop the sticky bombs. Probably taking a lot of health damage. Can't really see his health at this point in time. And he's gonna be moving forward. Oh, get the. No, oh, there's actually nothing here. Oh, sticky bombs. Sticky bombs. Shoot the sticky bombs. Okay, run away, run away! We've been outsmarted by sticky bombs. Run, my minions! And it. Worst sandwich throw we've ever seen. Medic picks it up. He has an Uber, so he can just at any point in time just go. And having a lot of engineers, you know, enemy team has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 engineers. 6 sentries are usually not a good idea because a heavy can just kill every one of them. And let's see. Okay, they have 3 level 3 sentries. How many dispensers do they have? They have 2. Meaning they can supply. They can literally supply this sentry with repairs. So here's the thing, if you're running low on dispensers and you know the enemy team is doing that, you can just shoot the sentries until it fucking dies, because they won't be able to repair it as much. And that's pretty common, you know, but everybody watches this show, you know, you always go dispenser first. Always, always, always. Goes on, we're gonna be going back here, doing roundabout. Yeah, take 2 here. Red's barrel is what he says as he barrels his way in here, and the spy zaps this, and goes on kills. And he's out of ammo, his only weakness, if there only was enough metal to go around. In fact, it is this time. He punches some dispensers, even though he could easily switch to his minigun right now. He has full ammo. Yes, good. Goes on learning about ammo and conservation. And that's like one thing about this build of loadouts, is that you're very minigun heavy, so if you run out of bullets, you're fucking... Like, if you have no sandwich, you just ate your sandwich, and you have no bullets, you are fucked. You are so fucked unless you can pick up some ammo. Because you will take mini-crits, and even after you pick up ammo, you will still take mini-crits for like another 3 seconds, so you gotta be careful about that. So this is what it's called, what I like to call engineering using your brain. So, usually when people... What the fuck is with this field of view? Alright, so... So, we have the brilliant engineers here who decided that, well, we're gonna lose this spawn as soon as this cart pushes here. So, these sentries won't actually shoot jack shit if blue team completely ignores everything and just pushes the cart into the front there. So, we got a guy here, he's gonna build a sentry right where everybody can fucking see it and take it out instantly. And he's like, well, that didn't work. Better fall back. So, you know, teamwork, fuck that. Better have 3 level 1 sentries at spawn. We have 1 level 2, things are looking good. And this guy's like, well, I guess I'm gonna help you now. We got a lot of engineers without hats. And oh no, our spawn's been fucked up. Jeez, who would ever have thought? If we only knew the map. Oh, what's that? Is that a single heavy? Let's see, yeah, shooting the things and like, yeah, well, we have no dispenser because fuck that. One engineer's like a bit ballsy and decides to feed the heavy some ammo. Helping goes on, you know, not run out. And this demo man is like, well, I'm just gonna kill everything. And this engineer is like, oh, yeah, put it over here, fuck that. And he's like, oh, pick up, run away. And goes on, is like, well, time for part 2, let's look around. We have some pro engineers here, and yeah, just kill that. And just gonna check around this corner. Oh, is this a sentry? That's a building. Excellent, I'll just kill that, and then I'll kill you. And you are all fucking dead as shit, and you should probably have more engineers. Because having 6 apparently wasn't enough when you had a spy and a heavy that killed everything. And then goes on, just proceeds to kill pretty much everything, so... One thing, if you play heavy and the enemy team is running something wonky that doesn't really work, you as a heavy will fucking wreck shit. You will kill everything and you will fucking win. victory. Good. That felt good, right? So we're going to look at the second last replay before we're going to finish up here on this heavy episode here. What was this one called? Yeah, great use of the gloves of running urgently, because you get additional speed. As we know, speed always beats power, and Heavy has a lot of power, so he has a lot of speed, so I guess that's broken in a way. But you take mini crits. You run faster, but you also die faster, so. So yeah, it goes on just punching a bunch of people really quickly. One, gates are open. I'm gonna shoot the mini sentry. Oh, fall back. Broken mini sentry. Foil our plans. Can't really do anything about this. We have a bit of a shootout going on here, taking out a medic, gonna hug the left wall, because that's usually what everybody does. You just run along the left wall and kill whatever you meet, and you take the high ground, then you just push the cart and you take the next point. So it goes on, having a medic friend, coming to assist him, which is very nice when you are playing heavy. You need that medic. Oh, no sentry! Okay, well, apparently they learned from their mistakes. They only have 3 engineers now instead of 8. That is pretty good. And yeah, they actually built a dispenser for us. Too bad, it's in an awful position. It's gonna get killed immediately. And look around, they even have a teleporter up and going, and he killed it as people went through, so that's unfortunate. But oh yeah, using gloves running early to get speed. Going with this Demo Man and Medic Buddy for our maximum ownage potage here. Uber being flashed on him and doing a very nice job of just absolutely destroying everything. And what we've seen a lot of players. Oh, there's soldier bombing in! Oh, I got this medic! Oh, Ghost is on! Oh, Ghost is on! You failed the master, you should have killed that soldier and saved your medic. And that sniper dot makes you nervous, and this engineer's like, well, wait, let's look at that again. That is actually the engineer doing the nope face, right there. So you have Ghost is on here, I think. Let's see, will this work? Yeah, here it goes on, with his funky hat and everything. And he's like shooting bullets and shit. He's like, yeah, look at the door. Sniping in the corner. Engineer's like, nope. That's a smart engineer. He knows what's up. He's like, well, heavy around a corner. Not going out there. I'm going to go back and build and spawn. Yes. Oh, Ghost is on. Not going to camp this door, because this door won't actually close, because his team like didn't even push the card. They just captured this right now. So there's going to be a huge gap where there's going to be reinforcements coming through here. This engineer, he's like, well, you know, the heavy wasn't here. I guess he ran off or died or something. But little did he know that Ghost is on his way. He's like, ninja heavying around. Yes, this is what you do when you're a ninja. You sneak around. There's actually no one here. And Ghost is on, can get in position and do something. And he grabs some ammo, even though he has full ammo. Yes, just for good measure. Make up for earlier. And oh yes, takes out a teleporter. He's gonna hang around and spawn. He's, oh, here they come. Get the engineer, get the under engineer. It's like, well, there's a heavy there. I mean, what do I do? He goes pyro, because pyros are good against heavies. Yes, good. And he's gonna go and get this heavy. Actually, he's not, because pyros fucking suck against heavy. He's gonna get absolutely destroyed inside the enemy spawn. And goes on, just goes and grabs his health kit as it respawns. And then he's like, well, I've been a ninja for a long enough time now, I should make my escape here. And this Devil Man is like, get that motherfucking heavy. And then we see a neatly placed dispenser, sentry placement, who's like, well, it's on the low ground, so unless the enemy just fucking drops down here at any point in time, we're gonna fucking die. And Gozon goes down there and fucking kills everything, and the cart hasn't really moved all far. He's gonna retreat now with the gloves running urgently, even though he's low on health. Then retreating with his team. Excellent. Doing good work. Oh, yes. This was a good one. So, doing a lot of work, killing people left and right, being a ninja. And he could not have done that ninja stuff without the gloves running urgently, actually. So, because he had that and it was no one around, it really benefited him, and it was actually in his favor. So you can see the strength of the gloves right there when you can do this. Those sort of things. He got a nice opening, and took the advantage that he was given to him because of English. And now he has Uber, and he just kills it. Oh, sentry! Yeah, that thing's easy to take out when it's level 1 and in the middle of the track. There is a pyro, the ex-engineer who decided to go pyro because pyros are utter shit against heavies. And then he dies! Oh yeah, you know why? Because there was a fucking mini-sentry, right? Fuck that bullshit. Woo! Alright, so we're gonna end with me on a strong note. Finally, we have a bit more interesting episode where you got more stuff to to use and stuff like that. So we're going to be playing on Frontier, 5CP map that is severely underplayed. I like it a lot because there's trains, and trains fucking wreck shit. They kill you. They rip you a new one, actually. They actually run you over and you just die. Uber or not. So we have me running out here. Let's see if we can get me a model. That would be very beneficial indeed. Let's see if I get hats this time. I should get hats. Oh yes, here's my hat loadout. Look at this fancy loadout. Black sunglasses, black hat, and a black tie here, as we have no hands going into this middle fight. Using gloves running urgently to get to the point as nearly as fast as Pyros. It's only a couple of, hammer units off, I guess. Gonna be moving forward, and oh shit, they're killing our medic. Kill the Pyro. Shit, alright. The Pyro actually kill our medic. Retreat. We're low on health, and use the gloves running urgently to escape. Like, sub soldier, I'll just have a little bite in this corner. And I will survive, most likely, yes. So, moving forward here and doing some more damage. Just doing pot shots at a distance. Seeing a spy, check your back. Oh, we see a medic. He's out of position. The target is medic. You're going to ignore everything else. Getting this medic is very important because we lost ours. We did get the medic, so that is nice. Bro, lots of bombs detonated before I went in. Nice premature detonation. Here we have a medic with the crits krieg. Excellent. So we're just gonna wait here for a bit, and we're gonna go back. And we're not gonna use those underground tunnels. Oh, shit. That's a heavy over there. All right, we can take him. And this is where... That's my phone, all right? That's my phone. I'm not kidding. That is my phone. It says charge me when low on battery. So, all right, so here we have... We saw a heavy run in here. We have no idea where he is. And there's a pyro down here. There's a bunch of action, but we haven't seen the heavy. Oh, he's having a sandwich. Uh-oh. Are you fucking... fucking ready for this? So our medic is like, well, fuck healing us. We are currently running the gloves running urgently. We are taking mini crits. He is not. Alright, so how do we do this? Alright, go in. Oh, punch him. Get away. Up with the minigun. Shoot the motherfucker. Yes! Whoops. And we fucking wrecked his shit. So let's see who sent me a message.
Alert. Our control point is being captured.
Alright, excellent. And then we fucking lose. Alright. But I actually rooted my phone so that I can change the low battery sound, so it actually says, charge me when I'm low on sound. And when it's fully charged, it says, I am fully charged. It's the best phone ever. So thanks to everybody who submitted this heavy topic. It's kind of boring, but it's not more fun than we make it here on the show. So tomorrow will be Try Hard Thursday, where we will look at something remotely interesting. I'll see if I can find an interesting game that we can watch. I will be, well, for you YouTube viewers, this is not going to matter, but for... later today, I will be streaming for Vanilla TV. We will be doing some. There's a Sixes game that I will be streaming, and Byton, suddenly Star Mia, will be casting it. So I won't actually say anything, but you will have my camera work. And maybe some secret sounds here and there. Oh, if they allow it. Last time I did that, they got really mad at me. Not really, they didn't. But we can pretend they did for greater effect. So for next week, I announced this a week ago. It's going to be the... Sniper Shutdown episode, mainly focused on Sniper with Razorback, and you're going to be playing Spy. And your mission is to shut down any Sniper activity on the other team, whatever the cost. So if you have the choice between killing a medic with a full Uber, making him drop it, or kill the Sniper with the Razorback, you kill the Sniper with the Razorback. That is your mission, that is your goal. Of course, you can kill other classes, but the minimum requirement is you have to kill at least one sniper on the other team. He doesn't have to have the Razorback, but you should have either kill him with a revolver, or Ambassador, or Enforcer, or Letanger, or what fucking ever. Try not to stab him, because we want to, like, emphasize that the Razorback does not protect you against spies, and you die just as much to them, regardless. So we're going to do that, and it's going to be very fun for you. Try and do something to that causes the enemy team to go snipers. Maybe you play a sniper yourself, and you kill a bit, and you trigger a lot of them to go sniper, and then you go spy, and you just kill shit. Or you can just ask them to go sniper, you know, if they're nice. So with that, we're going to conclude at this loadout, this one. Dominant loadout, heavy loadout, summarizing it for those who just tuning in, I guess. Minigun, really good. Sucks if you're out of ammo. That's pretty much it. It's pretty good unless you're out of ammo. Then, if you're out of ammo and out of a sandwich, this loadout fucking sucks. Because you can't do anything, really. But other than that, it's pretty good. So, thank you guys for watching. Be sure to join the Steam group. And I will see you on the next HiGPS show. Yay!